you know, it really pains us so much because we do not get anything out of the dam. No, the dam irrigates 80,000 hectares of Isabela, but not a single hectare for Cagayan. The dam generates power, and of course, Isabela, even if you know, the Biscay gets something out of it, Cagayan doesn't get anything out of it. And yet, no, pag nagpalabas sila ng tubig,
it brings a lot of damages for us, especially on the crops. That's why masakit talaga, whether it is the primary source of water that causes our destructive floods or not, it contributes to it. And if they could not really control it, that's the time talaga masakit sa amin, because we do not get anything out of that land.
Doon, kasi inihimok kayo ngayon na magsampa ng kaso laban sa MAGAT administrators or management. Sa tingin niyo po ba may basehan para gawin yun? O yun ang sinasabi ninyo, how many percent of it would you attribute to the swelling of Cagayan River because of the rains, no? The volume of rain? And how much would you attribute to the, well, sabihin na lang natin, no, the mismanaged or lack or unplanned release of water?
I wouldn't really know kung gaano, no, pero since the province do not get anything out of the operation of the dam, yes, except damages na nangyayari sa amin every time na nagkakaroon kami ng flooding, we could not help but try to find out. No? And an investigation from any of the agencies would be one. No? Maging source din namin kung we really have to fight it out with them and get what we should be ours. No? Or at least measure the damages brought about by these things. No? Because science could also elucidate an investigation of our scientists, hydrologists, whatever you call them. No? And siguro, that in a way would help us out kung talaga this is the one causing all the damages that we have. But definitely po, no? Nakikita namin, makita nyo lang, kahit sa video lang naman, kung makarelease sila, that is practically one river added to Cagayan River, no? That's just another tributary. Pag binuhusan mo lahat ng gusto, that's one big tributary na umaloy din in addition to that of the Cagayan River. So, pag-iita po namin that kahit pa lang kasi po, kung ni-stop din naman nila yung pag-release nila, nakikita po naman namin na madali po humupa yung bahagi naman dito sa amin. So we feel that this could have contributed, exacerbated yung flooding na nangyari sa amin. And pati yung paghupa po, no? Napakatagal po. And the more na tumatagal yung flooding sa amin, the more damages that our crops, our livestock, and practically everything, no? The way of life that we have here, no? Kahit lang po yung power namin, it has to be shut off pag nakaroon kami ng pan. No, and maghihintay po kami ng ilang oras na naman before we could put in our power dito sa Cagayan. Just like now, hindi po namin lahat nagkaroon ng power dito because we have to wait hanggang kumupa po yung aming flood. So, if you measure all of these things, I think, sabi ko, masakit yung loob namin dahil sabi ko nga, we're not getting anything out of the advantages that Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, and Ifugao is getting. And we get all the punishment because of the releases na hindi nila makontrol-control at times.